It's been over 5 years for me in New Zealand. I don't really have very close friends, and love seems impossible to find in New Zealand so far. My name is Nazik Alexander. I'm from Saudi Arabia. I've been arrested for being a trans woman. The first time I tried to play with the makeup, I was very young. I was 3 years old. My mom was on the phone talking, and she saw me climbing on her wardrobe and take her lipstick, apply some. She said, "Wait a second, let me see this animal, what he's doing." And she actually hit me on my hand and locked me out of the house for a few hours at the night. And for a kid, it was very scary. Saudi Arabia being one of the strict religious countries, by the law there, it's illegal to be LGBTQ. One day, the police found some photos of me dressing up as a woman. They decided to send me to prison for 2 years and 1 month with 200 lashes and 30,000 Saudi riyal fine. I didn't do anything to go to prison. And then I did some research online, where can I go with no visa? And they find out about New Zealand. So I spent all the money I have on the ticket to get to New Zealand. It was a terrifying journey. And once I arrived, I climbed asylum at the airport. Eliana is a Colombian intersex trans woman. I met her in 2016 in the Pride. It was my first Pride ever, and I was so excited for it.
And you were so pretty. I remember your curls and how beautiful you were.
My afro.
Yeah, and you have like this beautiful makeup, eyeliner. I'm so jealous.
It's an amazing feeling to have the freedom. I know I'm protected by the law. No one can harm me. So yeah, I don't care what people think. I just do what I feel comfortable with.
My country, there is pride, but I feel with honesty that pride maybe give a chance to some people to like be happy, but some of us feel really uncomfortable because we feel that we are not safe. So in New Zealand, I think it was the first time I felt safe about being in Pride. Not every intersex person identifies as part of the rainbow. But in my case, it was something that really reflected my identity. Even though I was assigned male when I was kind of 17 or 18, starting to kind of be rebellious, and I wanted to just, you know, what if I am dressing and I am performing this amazing role of being a woman? So I did such thing. I did such thing, and I did it in my neighborhood. And at that time, it was a very unsafe place. While I was dressing, like at that time, I would say, like a woman, actually, I was attacked in the street with a knife. And actually, that situation was like a moment in my life in which was like, I can't live my life here.
When I meet other rainbow refugees, actually, I feel happy for them because they managed to get here to New Zealand. But at the same time, I feel sad for the loss they had, because I know how hard it is.
As you know, like when you are a quota refugee, it's pretty much like the United Nations allocates a number of refugees and New Zealand brings them here, and New Zealand somehow kind of looks after them in terms of providing housing and making sure that they are resettled in the community. the experience was in general a very good experience, but I know that that's not always the case, because I think you mentioned me that you are a convention refugee.
For me, it was a different case than yours, because I came as an asylum seeker. I've been held at the airport for 24 hours. I had an interview with the immigration, and after that, they transferred me from the airport to the police station, where I spent 5 days in a cell. It was horrible. I was like, I ran away from Saudi Arabia because I don't want to go to prison. And now I am in prison. After 5 days, they transferred me to the refugees camp. They put me in the main block. So I wasn't very comfortable there. Even like the bathroom, I have to wait until everyone go to sleep so I can use the bathroom. I spent 4 months in the refugees camp, but because my case was very clear, I had all the evidence, I got approved to stay in the country as a refugee, but they still like, they didn't give me any help when I got the approval. They said to me, just leave the camp. I said, where should I go? I'm terrified. I don't speak the language. I don't have money. I don't have anyone here in the country. I don't know where to go. In general, I think a lot of locals, they don't know what the experienced refugees go through, or asylum seekers. Some of them actually very angry because we are refugees. They think we here to take their jobs or take their money or something like that, but it's not true. We just try to find a safe place for us. Within the rainbow community itself here in New Zealand, you will find racism, discrimination, bullying, and this is horrible.
My dear, and what are your hopes for the future?
Maybe we're still facing some bad experiences with acceptance and discrimination. But I think we can make a change. I'm a proud Kiwi now, and I really hope that Kiwi people open up their hearts for us and try to learn about us. Because we need them, we need their love, we need their support. We've been isolated in our home countries, and we don't want to experience the same here again.